Finally, we get to the point where we can talk about the grave of optimizer. In this video, we're going to be focusing on the inspiration of this algorithm. There's no mathematical equation. That's what we'll be discussing in the next video. So I'm going to talk about the origin of this algorithm because I invented it in 2014, but the idea started, I think, 2012. I can give you a bit of background. Maybe you find it interesting. If not, you can fast forward this video. You don't have to listen to this. But some people find it interesting, and I keep getting this question, how you come up with this idea. I'm not saying it's a brilliant idea in the world. It's a, you know, groundbreaking idea. But it was interesting, and I'm happy that it impacted a lot of people's lives, and people, you know, use it in their career. So I was in my home country, Iran, and a friend of mine invited me for a dinner. We were a couple of friends chatting, and then he said, I bought a movie called The Gray. And I said, he said, do you want to watch it? I said, yeah, why not? Let's watch it together. And this movie, The Gray, was the beginning of this algorithm, to be honest. And I'm sure you wouldn't expect that, a movie. But in this movie, they talk about, you know, different types of gray wolves, like alpha, beta, delta, and omega, and their strength. And basically, the main actor will have to fight the alpha, which is the best wolf in the pack. And it was interesting, and I thought, that's very interesting. Let's see, let's do a bit of research more about, you know, gray wolves and see how they live, their social life and things like that. And overall, their intelligence, how they really come up with these kind of, you know, packs and well-organized pack and find much, much larger prey than themselves. So that was the idea. That was the beginning and that movie. Then I started to read a lot of articles, talk to a lot of people, and I found good stuff in there. And from my reading, I found two aspects of gray wolf very interesting. First one, social hierarchy. Second one, hunting mechanism. And these are the inspiration of the GWO or the gray wolf optimizer. I'm going to take you through them all briefly, and then we'll start the next video. So social hierarchy of particular interest is that they have a very strict social dominant hierarchy. We've got four types of wolf in a pack. They might look the same, but this is just the power pyramid. Alpha, followed by beta, delta, and omega. So let's start with alpha. So alpha is the leader, can be male or female, and is the most. It is responsible for making decision about hunting, sleeping place, time to wake up, and so on. Of course, these are based on a study that I've extracted these based on, you know, a lot of papers in this area, journal articles in this area. Not in the computer science, of course, in biology and things like that. The alpha's decisions are dictated to the pack, so they have to follow it. It's a bit of dictatorship, you know, pack or mechanism. However, some kind of democratic behavior has also been observed, in which an alpha follows the other wolves in the pack, particularly beta and delta. In gathering, the entire pack acknowledges alpha by holding their tail down, not waggle their tongue. The alpha wolf is also called the dominant wolf, since his or her orders should be followed by the whole pack. The alpha wolves are only allowed to mate in the pack. Interestingly, the alpha is not necessarily the strongest member in the pack, but the best in terms of managing the pack. So management skill is very important, you know, it seems, in the pack of wolves too. This shows that the organization and discipline of a pack is much more important than its strength. So just to keep it simple, alpha is the leader, is the one who leads the whole pack. Next level, beta wolf. The second level in the hierarchy of wolf is beta. The betas are are subordinate wolves that help the alpha in decision making and other pack activity. The alpha wolf, the beta wolf, can be either male or female. Again, gender doesn't matter. At least in the animal world, doesn't matter. It seems, which is good, much better than some countries. Anyway, and he or she is probably the best candidate to be the alpha in case of the alpha wolves passes away or become very old. So that's a good candidate. It's like a king and princess. The beta wolf should respect the alpha, but commands the other lower wolf as well. It plays the role of an advisor to the alpha and discipliner of the whole pack. The beta reinforces the alpha commands throughout the pack and gives feedback to the alpha. It's like a deputy, you know, like vice chancellor and deputy vice chancellor, right? So now we are talking about deputy vice chancellor. Now we are getting to the pro vice chancellor, the omega wolf. The lowest rank, hang on, the omega wolf is not the pro vice chancellor, my bad. That's delta wolf. But I purposely jumped to the omega because it's hard to define the delta based on my reading. So the lowest rank gray is omega. The omega plays the role of scapegoat. Omega wolves always have to submit to all other dominant wolves. They are the last wolves that are allowed to eat most of the time. Poor guys, it may seem the omega is not an important individual in the pack, but it has been observed that the whole pack face internal fighting and problem in case of losing the omega, because they need to have someone to fight with, I think. This is due to venting a violence and frustration of all wolves by the omega. So naturally, they have to vent it that way. Again, poor little guys. This assists satisfying the entire pack and managing the dominance structure. In some cases, the omega is also babysitters in the pack. So are the weak ones. And everything else is delta. If a wolf is not alpha, beta, or omega, he or she is called subordinates or delta in some references. Delta wolves have to submit to alpha and betas, but they dominate the omegas. Scouts, sentinels, elders, hunters, and caretakers belong to this category. Scouts are responsible for watching the boundaries of the territory and warning the pack in case of any danger. Sentinels protect and guarantee the safety of the pack. Elders are the experienced wolves who used to be alpha and or beta, but now downgraded probably for the because of the age or things like that, strength, stamina, and things like that. Hunters helps alpha and beta when hunting prey and providing food for the pack. Finally, the caretaker are responsible for caring for the weak, ill, and wounded wolves in the pack. And we'll have also babysitters up there. So in addition to the social hierarchy, which is very interesting, and there's a lot of documentary you can watch to better understand this, and it's very interesting how they have that sort of, you know, power pyramid at the same time, you know, dictatorship, but democratic a little bit too. So in addition to that, group hunting is another interesting social behavior of gray wolf. According to this guy, Moro et al., this reference, which is very interesting to read, the main phases of gray wolf hunting are as follows. Tracking, chasing, approaching the prey, that's one. Number two, pursuing, encircling, harassing the prey until it is stopped or it is stationary. And number three, attack toward the prey. And of course, they have to do it collectively because normally they you know, they eat or they hunt either sort of animals that are much faster than them, like a rabbit, or much bigger, like a buffalo or something. So they need to collaborate. They need that sort of hunting mechanism. Otherwise, they all die of starvation. Here's a good photo from the same reference that I show you, and exactly that's what I use in my journal publication in this algorithm too. So if you look at number one, that is where they chase, approach, and track the prey. So you try to chase it. And number two, B to D, so that one, these two, pursue, harass, and encircle. So try to encircle so they don't get damaged that much while trying to, you know, make the prey tired and exhausted. And once it happens, after probably a few hours in case of this big buffalo, when the prey is stationary, they try to attack one by one until, you know, the prey, you know, dies because of, you know, blood loss or anything else. And that's exactly, these are the inspiration of the Grave of Optimizer. And in the next video, I'll show you how I created mathematical equation to mimic the same behavior. It's complex, of course. It's a very complicated sort of intelligence in nature. You can't simulate all aspects of it, but I'll show you how I simplify things, look at it from one dimension, and came up with these, came up with some equation to, you know, to basically find an optimal solution for an optimization problem. So thanks for watching, and next video will be a lot more mathematical. In this video, we focus on theory and things like discussions and inspiration. Not my field, of course, and I assume it's not your field. We are computer scientists or engineers, so you'll find next video more mathematical, so we'll probably enjoy it more than this. Thanks for watching.